Hello friends, so in this video we will see how to overcome internal resistance that creates obstacles in our path to reach our goals. You go through self-sabotage or procrastination, you get stuck in one place. So there are two types of experience, one of peace, happiness, and you want to feel these positive emotions. And then there are experiences causing discomfort like rejection, embarrassment. You want to avoid those states. But what happens when we unconsciously associate these feelings with our goals or the behaviors and actions that will lead to the goal? And so we cannot move forward and get stuck. So consider if you are a salesperson who wants to call a prospective customer. So the act of calling is now associated with rejection, embarrassment, failure. And this is the reason why people start and stop things. Like diets, it is also the reason why people go to the gym and then stop. They are also avoiding some emotional states. The reason for all this is in our past that we cannot change. So we have to change the things in the present. So first, you have to write down the specific goal that you want to achieve. Like you want to be fit, so you want to go to the gym, whatever the goal may be. Then you have to write down the positive things that will happen when you have achieved the goal. So you have to ask yourself, what's important to me about this? What it will do for me when I achieve this? How do I get to feel once I have accomplished this goal? And as you do that, you start coming up with answers, and you will pay attention to these emotional states like happiness, joy, freedom, love, peace. And then you know you have the right feelings. I want you to also look at the behavior of self-sabotage that you are doing. Write down what negative emotions you are avoiding by engaging in that sabotage, like not calling your potential customer to avoid rejection or embarrassment. Write that down. And you have to really get honest with yourself. You have to write down the reality of what this behavior is actually costing you. Write down how this self-sabotage is actually causing you to experience negative emotions. So now we are saying that this self-sabotage behavior is actually embarrassing and humiliating. And what are the consequences of this behavior? Over a period, say 1 year, 2 years, 5 years, how much it is costing you over a period of time? And the more honest you are, the more pain you are going to now associate with that self-sabotage behavior. Once you have done that, write down how actually engaging in the behavior of overcoming self-sabotage is going to be positive, and associate yourself with it. So put yourself in that place of you being successful overcoming that sabotaging behavior. Use your full mind and body. associate with that wonderful feeling. You've conquered this problem for good. What do you get to feel? Step into it, feel it, write it down, the positive consequences of that for the rest of your life, what it means to you a year from now, 5 years from now, 10 years from now, how you are going to feel about yourself at an emotional level. Feel that emotion and you will see that the self-sabotaging behavior will slowly disappear. And imagine going inside your body and thank that part of yourself which was creating the self-sabotage behavior. Because the intention behind that behavior is good, to avoid negative emotions. And now explain to that part of body that by taking actions to achieve your goals, you will actually be able to feel the way you want to feel. So you can even imagine how in the past you might have self-sabotaged, but now you will feel bad about it because you have changed that association, the emotional state that was associated with it. So whenever you have this resistance, and you will have resistance for some things, you have to do this exercise. Because in the end what happens is that you have to go out there and do these things which will help you achieve your goals. So these are very important things.